2 years ago, I got the highest score in the world for my Computer Science GCSE. Here's how I did it. I'm going to be telling you the revision and exam techniques I implemented for both the theory and programming aspects. However boring you think it is, there's no escaping computer science theory, as it makes up 50% of your GCSE. Having good revision notes is especially crucial to success in the theory paper. Many computer science textbooks have much more content in it than you actually need in the exam, so it's important you make notes with the specification on the side, because it also ensures that you don't miss out any key points. Make sure that you're summarizing textbook content in your own words as well. This way, your notes will be as concise as possible. Here's top tip number one. Try to find past paper questions for every subtopic in the specification. For example, many people find the networks topic quite challenging, but you'll quickly find that questions are quite repetitive and formulaic once you start incorporating mark scheme answers in your revision notes. One thing to remember though, you must relate your answers to the context of the made-up situation in the question, besides regurgitating what you've memorized, in order to get all the marks. If you prefer using flashcards for revision, try having past paper questions on one side and the keywords from the mark scheme answers on the other side. Tip number two, try to predict what types of question will come up and spend extra time preparing for the common questions. For example, in systems architecture, there will always be a question on how different factors affect CPU performance. In memory and storage, there'll be comparison questions on the benefits and drawbacks of different storage devices, and also what can affect the quality and size of images and sound. In the networks topic, there'll be a question on the process of requesting a web page through the DNS. There's also likely to be an essay-style question on ethics, which you can prepare for by coming up with specific examples or case studies. Revising for these high likelihood questions will give you the maximum return for minimum investment if you ever get to that stage where you need to cram for the exam the night before. Here's the hidden gem. The resource that got me the highest score in the world was Smart Revise. It's a brilliant website with pre-made flashcards with key terms for every single topic, as well as every single past paper question on it, which you can sort by question type like multi-choice to help you recall facts, or long answer questions to help you synthesize and explain what you've absorbed. Of course, you could also search questions by topics to target your weaknesses. If you've been following the channel, you'll know that doing past paper questions is the single best way to revise, and Smart Revise helps you to do it efficiently and interactively at a bargain of a price. And if you'd rather spend £4.50 on a pizza instead, the creators of Smart Revise, Craig and Dave, have freely available YouTube videos for every topic in the specification. Now you've filled your brain with information, how about exam technique? A helpful practice is to structure your answers like a mark scheme. Put one idea per bullet point and try to include a few more bullet points than marks available, especially if you've got extra time at the end, in case one of your points isn't on the mark scheme. In computer science, there are often multiple ways of saying the same thing, so be sure to include all of those in your answers by separating them with slashes. Let's look at a specific example in my exam script. This question is essentially asking why a text document can only be compressed using lossless compression. Now, one of my points here was that using lossy compression would make data unintelligible, slash useless, slash change its meaning. Looking at the mark scheme, I would have only got marks for saying that the meaning would have changed. So if I only wrote down one of those phrases, I could have lost the mark. So how about tackling the tricky long answer essay question? There'll always be bullet points telling you what you should cover, so it's a good idea to spend 2 to 3 minutes planning. Split each bullet point into a few subtopics, each of which will form a few sentences in your mini essay. Remember that it's an 8 or 9 mark question, meaning that you should spend 10 to 15 minutes overall, so a paragraph per bullet point will be enough. So how about programming? Let's start with the reality. You don't have to start programming at the age of 4 or build your own large language model to be able to program at the level required at GCSE. To be honest, I only started learning Python at school in year 10. With programming, revision notes will be less helpful, as it's more of a skill, a way of thinking, or a language instead of a set of hard facts you need to remember. As with every language, there's a vocabulary you need to learn, and in this case, that's the syntax. There are freely available cheat sheets online for your chosen programming language, but it's better to make one yourself that tailors to what you need to know for the exam. Of course, practice makes perfect in programming. Start by identifying all the skills you need to know for your exam, such as loops, arrays, and file handling. The best websites for learning and practicing programming are freely available online, such as W3 Schools or Geeks for Geeks. There you can find coding exercises based on what skills you want to work on, and choose different difficulty levels. If you're in year 10, set aside a small amount of time every week to practice by doing a few coding exercises. If you're really up for a challenge, you could try out the harder problems on coding websites like Project Euler or Codeforces. But for the GCSE, your main focus is getting the syntax right and solving relatively basic problems. If you're in year 11, focus on consolidation by doing past paper programming questions. In the exam, you'll need to program by writing code with pen and paper, so you won't have the luxury of auto-completing keywords or dynamic syntax checking, or even just running the code to check for errors. So the best way to practice programming for the exam, even though it feels really weird, is writing solutions to past paper questions on paper instead of on a computer. This way, you'll also be able to highlight common errors, such as forgetting to cast from string to integer, getting your start and end indices wrong, or missing out quotation marks. It's really helpful to compile a list of these common programming mistakes, so you can remind yourself to check for them during the exam, and avoid losing marks you didn't deserve to lose. If you're taking Computer Science GCSE, I wish you the best of luck, and I hope that this video has been helpful. If you've got any extra questions, please drop them in the comments below, and I'll try my best to get to them. We've also made a general GCSE advice video you can check out here, and we'll be making more subject-specific videos for English Lang, English Lit, Maths and the Sciences. So make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on the advice that got me and ZJ all 9s at GCSE.